Hello.
Hello, hello.
Hello, hello. Hello, everybody.
Hello, everybody.
How are you today?
I'm very happy.
Because it's Thursday.
Yes.
I knew it.
Yeah, I knew it.
Yeah, I knew.
Good evening.
Hello, welcome. How are you today?
Very fine.
Okay, I'm glad to hear that you are fine. How was your day?
Hello?
How was your day?
Cansado.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Ay, sí, cansadísimo.
Good evening, teacher.
Hello, good evening. Welcome back to your English class. How are you today? Tired. Uh-huh. Happy.
¿Qué dice?
Happy.
Yes, I am.
Okay, excellent. Tired but happy. Okay, good. Como decimos, hoy es el viernes chiquito. Okay, so welcome everybody. Paolo, ¿ya vino? No ha venido Paolo todavía. Okay, so we're going to start with the class. Thank you everybody that you can just send me your homework. The last homework is level number one. Okay. So today is Thursday, March 18, 2021. Okay, we have the topic. The topic is review about unit one. Yes. Our agenda is very short. So we have the grading. We have the review and practice the grammar about the unit one. We're going to practice all the time. So practice and practice and practice again. Yes, you should practice the language every single time. When you have the opportunity, yes, try to speak. If you have a friend, relatives that speak English, try to do it. If you don't have the word in that precise moment, you try to explain what you like to say to the other person. So try to practice every single day. 15 minutes or 30 minutes is enough to learn the new language. Okay, the general objective, students will be able to review and practice the units about the unit one. Yes. Okay. So we're going to start with the review. Okay. So what do you remember about the first class? ¿Qué se recuerda de la primera clase que tuvimos aquel martes? No recuerdo la fecha, pero sí fue un martes.
This is a
23 de febrero fue, teacher. Bueno.
Oh, my goodness.
Saludo.
Gran poder.
Thursday, 23.
Saludos.
Thursday.
How are
Thank you?
Thank
you. Okay. We were discussing about the gradings, right? What is the meaning of grading, Olga? ¿Qué aprendió? Los saludos, madre.
Nice to meet you.
Okay. Yes. Ah, sí, es como decir hola. Todos los días nos decía eso la teacher. ¿Qué aprendió? Solo a decir hello.
Greetings.
Greetings. Okay. Great. Yes, we were discussing about the different greetings, how we're going to say hello to another person. Yes. And also, we were discussing about the subject pronoun and the possessive adjective. Do you remember about that? ¿Te recuerda de eso?
I remember.
Okay.
I remember.
Okay, excellent. Okay, tell me, what do you remember? How we're going to use it? ¿Cómo lo vamos a utilizar? Tell me an example using she.
She's beautiful.
Okay, she's beautiful. Okay, tell me an example about the subject possessive adjective.
Her umbrella.
Okay, her umbrella. Umbrella, I forgot that is with two L's. Okay, her umbrella is big, right? Okay, easy.
Easy.
I will tell you something. We're going to review almost all the topics that we were studying during this level. Yes, but you can stop anytime that you have reforce that topic. Si usted le necesita que le reforcemos un tema, deténgame, yo me detengo y se lo explico con más detenido este momento, ¿verdad? Porque la idea de este repaso es para que les quede ya más clarito y recordar todos los temas que estuvimos viendo durante todo este nivel. ¿Sí? Ok. Do you remember about the verb to be?
I remember.
Okay. Tell me, what is the verb to be?
Is are.
Okay. When we're going to use am?
I.
Excellent. Is.
Is she it?
Excellent. Are.
You are going.
Excellent. Okay. Good. So, and also we were discussing about the contractions. We were discussing about the negative and the negative with the contraction. And also we were discussing about the interrogative. Yes. Easy.
Yes. Easy, teacher.
Okay. Very easy. Another topic that we were discussing was the ABC. Yes? I don't know which letters is a little bit complicated for you. I don't know if you did some exercise with those letters. If you have issues or difficult with the I, so what you should do? Practice, right? The pronunciation and also write some words that start with that letter. Yes? So, for example, if you have issues with the S, so you should practice with that word or letter, sorry, in this case, letter. You're going to write some words with that letter and practice. Yes?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, vamos a cantar el ABC o lo vamos a decir, pero en una sola voz. Okay.
Okay.
Afinando gargantas, por favor. Okay. One. Two. Espérense. ¿Verdad que ya iba? Okay. One. Two. Three. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z, Y, Z, Y, Z. Excellent. ¿Saben qué es lo curioso?
Se oyó todo chistoso.
No. Aparte de eso,
cantando de nuevo.
Aparte de eso, que es casi solo tonos de mujeres, escuché.
Ahora solo varones, solo los hombres.
Solo los hombres.
Eso les iba a decir, vaya, mujeres, silencio ese micrófono, por favor, Sandra. Olga, quiero ver quién más lo tiene abierto, quiero ver. Vaya, hombres, es su turno de brillar con esas preciosas voces que tienen. Vaya, si no los escucho, no sé qué le puede hacer. One, two,
vaya, les three.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Okay, thank you. Applause for you. Okay, good. ¿Saben por qué solo escuché el tono de solo mujeres? Porque estaba revisando que solo dos hombres tenemos ahorita. Solo está Giovanni,
teacher,
y está Luis, creo.
No ha venido el cumpleañero, no se ha conectado, ¿verdad?
No, solo dos hombres tengo ahorita, ¿ve? Con razón. Bueno. Se escuchaba más el tono de las mujeres. Sí. Ok, thank you for that participation, guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I appreciate it a lot. Okay, so, mi consejo, practique las letras que se le dificultan y haga palabras con esas para que usted la ande pronunciando, ¿sí? Ese es mi consejo. Okay, so, do you remember about this? You have the meaning of Mr., Mrs., Miss, Miss, yes, and you have the meaning of each one, yes. Tienen el significado de cada uno. Do you remember about this?
Mr. is
easy. I remember.
Okay, excellent. Easy.
Easy.
Perfect. Okay, do you remember about the numbers? Yes.
Yes.
Also, we were discussing about the numbers.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. So be careful when you are going to write the numbers because those letters or words is a little bit tricky because when we are going to write four, in the case of 40, so we are going to eliminate the U and so be careful with that, okay? So we have also the example of the 12. It's similar to 20, similar, but not the same, similar. And also, I guess it's 19 or 90, yes. 90 with 9, yes. Let me check, 90, 90, no, okay. So, but we have to take care of those things when we're going to write them, okay? Easy. You should practice.
Easy, teacher.
Just practice yes. And practice, yes, and you are going to be better than today, okay? So, do you remember about how or when we're going to use the apostrophe?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, tell me an example.
Yes, I remember.
A mí me cuesta usarlo.
Me
cuando
cuesta.
Yo estoy ya trabajando, me cuesta saber dónde voy a aplicar el Margot con lo de la casa, por ejemplo. Y cuando no, porque digo, we want to go to the house Margot o house o Margot of house. No, ahí es donde.
Vaya, le voy a dar una clave. Usted no va a utilizar el of Margot. ¿Yes? Usted no va a utilizar el de Margot. Porque el of en español lo queremos meter así como la casa de María, por ejemplo. Entonces queremos siempre estar poniendo esas palabritas. Entonces, ¿qué hace el apóstrofe? Está como eliminando ese O, ¿sí? Por eso nosotros ponemos Margot's house, como que usted diga la tienda de Olga, ¿sí? Entonces, en vez de decir la tienda de Olga, que sería store of Olga. Se dice Olga's store.
Ah, ok.
Primero vamos a poner la persona que es dueña. En este caso es usted y usted dueña de una tienda. Entonces sería Olga's store. Está diciendo primero lo que usted está poseyendo, decirlo, por decirlo así, que usted es dueña de esa tienda. ¿De quién es la tienda? De Olga. No sé si me, hoy sí, sí me entiende.
Hoy sí.
¡Yay! Gracias. Ya me puedo graduar. Yay. Sí. Ok. No sé si alguien más tiene una pregunta con respecto a este tema. No.
No, teacher.
No.
Ok. So we're going to continue with the article. Yes. We're going to talk about the article. In this case, we have a and an. Do you remember the difference between them? Because they are the same. The meaning is the same. But we have the different. Which is the difference between those articles? ¿Cuál es la diferencia?
Que singular y plural.
Ah, necesito que se saque eso.
Que
es singular y plural.
O una.
Va antes de alguna palabra que empiece con consonante. Y también dependiendo del sonido. Y an va antes de una palabra que empiece con vocal. Igual, tiene que ver mucho el sonido de dicha palabra.
Perfecto. Yes, thank you. Ok, recuerden que esto, el artículo nos va a ser para que las cosas que vayamos a decir estén todas en singular, ¿sí? Porque estamos diciendo un o una. Ok, un celular, un lápiz, no tengo una manzana. Ok, algo con A o U. No sé.
Umbrella.
Umbrella. Digamos que quiero ver. Este es un borrador. ¿Cómo sería? An eraser.
Eraser.
Aquí está un borrador.
An eraser.
Aquí está un borrador, pero de los antiguos. ¿Sí? Borrador. An eraser. ¿Yes? Ok. So, no me confunda eso que es para plural y singular. Solo son para singulares. ¿Ok?
Ok, teacher.
Good. So, and don't forget that we're going to use an for vowel sounds. And also, we're going to use it for consonant. And we have an exception. Yes, we have exceptions. Because we have here this one. We can write it with a consonant. But the pronunciation is on. Yes, honor. An honor. Yes, we eliminate the H in this case. Yes, and we have the also, we have a university. University. Yes, vowel, but the pronunciation is like you. Yes? Easy.
Yes.
Easy, teacher.
Okay, excellent. Perfect. Magnific. Okay. Okay, we have here also the next rule that is talking about the pronunciation about the plurals. Do you remember about how we are going to use it?
Telephones.
Okay, excellent. So that is for telephone. That is end with E.
Telephone.
Yes. So we're going to pronounce telephones. Termina con E y le vamos a agregar solo la S, pero vamos a pronunciarlo como que fuera telephones. Yes, try to do it that sound. Yes. Okay, don't forget that one. These words end with S, X, Z. C-H-S-H, we are going to add E-S, and the pronunciation is going to be is, is, classes, boxes, sizes, matches, dishes, like is, yes? We have this one when the words end with B, D, G, L, M, N, R, B, Y, A, E, O, and so on. I, you, we're going to pronounce Z. Yes, dogs, girls, moms, fans. With the practice, we're going to do it naturally. Yes. So because we are Hispanic, the language is Spanish. So that's why we have some issues when we're going to pronounce the words. But we have also, when we're going to do the pronunciation, we're going to do it with the words that end with F, K, P, T, N, T, H. Yes, groups, books, lips, natural, right? Cats is the more easy pronunciation, okay? So we were also talking about the verb to be and how we're going to do some questions. In this case, we were discussing about the how we're going to call these ones. These and these. ¿Cómo le llamamos a esos? ¿Se recuerda? No.
Es plural y singular, si no mal me recuerdo.
Sí, correcto. Plural y singular. Pero ¿cómo le llamamos a this and this?
Es el aquí, ahí, ¿verdad? O okay. ahí, pero no me acuerdo cómo se le llama. Esto.
Ajá. Eso. Demostrativo.
Yes. Esto. Demonstrative. Excellent. Yes. Okay, so we're going to use demonstratives with this and this, right? So, okay, we have the complement and don't forget to use the question, right? When we're going to do some question using the verb to be, when we have the sentence, for example, this is my wallet. So we're going to change. We're going to write the verb be at the beginning, then demonstrative. How we're going to call these ones? Uh-huh. ¿Cómo le llamamos a eso?
Possessive adjective.
Good, excellent, easy. Easy, right?
Easy.
Perfect.
Easy.
Okay, we were also talking about the WH question. Yes, in this case, we were discussing about who, what, when, where, how, why, and we have the meaning of those. Yes, so in that case, we were discussing about using for as in or at what place or position is someone or something. Yes. And also we were discussing about these examples. We were discussing with the WH question word. Where are you from? Where is your friend? Where are you and Luisa from? Do you remember about this? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Also, we were discussing about the article there. Yes. We have the difference between them. When we're talking about the vowel sound, the apple or the apple? What do you think?
Huh? The apple.
Okay, the apple. Yes. And when we're talking about consonant?
The.
Yes. Aquí no tengo la correcta forma de cómo lo usamos fonéticamente porque a esa pronunciación the es así como la schwa le llamamos. La schwa. Y la schwa va al revés. Es como que esa E la tenga al revés. Entonces nosotros fonéticamente la conocemos como la schwa. ¿Yes? Pero es pronunciación do. ¿Yes? Do. Okay, I don't know if you have any question at this moment.
Yo en esa, teacher, si nosotros decimos the apple, estaría diciéndolo mal.
Ah, sí, correcto. Gramaticalmente, de pronunciación fonética, mejor dicho, es este, sí, pero le vamos a entender. Uh-huh. Porque la pronunciación es di.
Con cada una vez que comienza vocal. En vocal.
En vocal, di. The apple.
Gracias.
The elephant. Ok. Good. ¿Se recuerda el uso? ¿Cómo iba, con qué íbamos a utilizar el the? ¿Y cómo no lo íbamos a utilizar? ¿Se recuerda? Yes. Ok. Good. We also, we were discussing about the preposition. Do you remember about the preposition? In that case, we were discussing about the preposition of place. Yes, we were discussing in that moment in front of, behind, on, next to, and under. Do you remember about this? Yes or no?
I remember.
Okay. That is in the page 13, I guess. 13. Yes, that was for page 12 and 13. But it starts in the page 11. Yes, 11, 12, and 13. If you're looking for that information, it's there. Okay. Okay, and that day we were discussing about some questions. And on the page 13, you have an image that we were discussing. That where is his camera, because we were talking about Joyce, I guess. Yes, Joy. We're discussing about the stuff of Joy. And we did this question. Yes? Easy.
Easy, teacher.
Okay, excellent. So we also were discussing then the topic that was the intonation. Do you remember about that? The intonation about the countries, the nationalities, and the languages? Yes.
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. We also were discussing about the age. Do you remember about that? How we're going to use how to ask the age to anyone. Cuando preguntamos la edad, perdón, a cualquier persona. Okay, when we're going to say how old is she, we're talking about a woman. Yes, when we're talking about how old are you, right? Okay, how old are you? They're talking about you, right? Okay, do you remember that we said that when we're going to say something, she's about 43 years old. Yes. Ella tiene más o menos la edad de 43 años. Yes, do you remember that? Or when you're going to say, I am in my 30s. Si no quiere decir la edad que tiene 37, 38. Estoy en mis 30. Okay, do you remember about that?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. So I will stop to sharing right now and I will pass the attendance. So please tell me, I'm here, teacher, present. Okay, just give me a second. I will looking for that right now.
Teacher, ¿y es correcto decir here I am?
Yes, here I am.
Okay.
Okay, here I am. Okay, give me a second right now. Okay, I'm looking for that information. So give me a second. Uy, okay. Karen Lisette.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Catherine Liliana. Hey, Lourdes Rocibel.
I'm here.
Thank you. Luis Mario.
Present.
Luisa Cheyenne. Okay, Magali Rachel.
Present.
Thank you. Marilyn Dayana. Marilyn Dayana.
Present.
Thank you. Maria Amalia.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Maria Angelina.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Maria Ruth. Marielos Guadalupe.
Teacher, present.
Marielos.
10 horas después, no, María Ruth.
No, yo soy Marielos.
Ok, thank you.
Pero las dos estamos presentes.
Excelente. Marta Roxana. Marta Roxana. Marta Stephanie.
Present, teacher.
Está, thank you. Mirna Elizabeth. Mónica María.
Present, teacher.
Moris Isaí. Moris. Noemí Lizette.
Present, teacher.
Ok, thank you. Olga Lilian.
Present, teacher.
Paolo. Ok, Rafael Alexander. Ronald Giovanni.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Rosa María del Milagro.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Samuel Isaí. Sandra Maritza.
Present.
Thank you. Sandra Melissa.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Santos Miguel.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Silvia Esperanza.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Sonia Giselle.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Soraya Guadalupe.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. And Thelma Guadalupe.
Present, teacher.
Excellent. Thank you, everybody. So this is the first time. So good. Just give me a second. I will put my short presentation. Okay, just give me a second. Give me a second, I'm looking for that. Okay, so it's here. Just, it's here. Okay, so we also were discussing about the WH question. In this case, we have the use for. So when we're going to use how, we are going to use it for ask for the age, right? Do you remember about this? Do you have this information? Yes. Do you have this information?
Yes.
Okay, perfect.
Teacher, teacher, yes. E-O-H-O-W, solamente se puede decir como cuántos o tiene otro?
Como el how. ¿Solo el how o how much o how many? Ajá.
¿Cómo?
No le comprendo. ¿Qué me está preguntando?
En la palabra H-O-W solamente se puede traducir como cuántos.
Ah, pero cuando está sola, how... la podemos poner así como how old are you, how are you, también lo podemos utilizar how much, how many, yes, tiene varios.
Ah, ya, yeah, ya, yeah. Gracias.
Okay, you're welcome. Good, good, good. Okay, so we have also in the simple present, yes, we are going to use the WH question with the verb to be. Yes, in that case, we were using with the pronoun. Yes, and at the end, we were using with the question mark. Don't forget that when you are going to do a question, don't forget to use the question mark at the end. Yes, easy. Any question?
No question.
Okay. Easy. Okay. So also we were discussing about this. Yes. We were discussing about the WH question word. Yes. And we also we were discussing about when we're going to use art is because it's plural. Yes. And also when we're going to ask, how are you? Or where are you? Yes. Where are you? Where is my book? Where are you studying? Where are my glasses? Easy. Okay, also, we were discussing about the verb where. Yes, we are going to use this verb when we are going to use it with clothes. Yes, I'm wearing a white blouse. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Do you remember about the difference between the personal pronoun, possessive adjective, and the possessive pronouns? ¿Se recuerda eso?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, excellent. Yes, we were working with the difference between them. Yes, the possessive adjective, and we also were discussing about the possessive pronouns. Easy. Just practice, right? Yo sé que es un poquito complicado, pero con la práctica yo sé que lo vamos a lograr. Okay. Easy. Do you have any question? No?
Yo se me olvidó decirle que no había comprendido bien la palabra W E A R.
AR, let me check. This one. Yes, this one.
En la diapositiva 35.
Where? Where? Sorry, where?
Yes.
Okay, esta la vamos a utilizar, es el verbo de usar, vestir. Estoy usando. Okay, lo vamos a usar con ropa.
Okay, thanks.
Yes, you're welcome. Okay, this one. Do you have any question with the apostrophe? In that case, in that occasion, we were discussing with who? Whose, sorry, whose? Do you remember about the meaning of whose? De quién?
De quién? De quién?
Okay. Whose cell phone is this?
Is the teacher.
Okay. It's teachers.
It's okay. Teachers.
Yes. It is teachers. Okay. And don't forget that when we're going to use the names with the ending with S, we're going to add the apostrophe at the end. Yes. We can use it that form, and also we can use with this, but it's your choice. Solo a ver la diferencia cuando lo escribe, cuando lo pronuncia es casi similar. Lourdes, Lourdes. Okay? Luis, Luis. Yes, Luis. Almost the same. Okay, so we were discussing about the demonstrative pronouns. Do you remember about this? These and those. We have the singular, plural, near, far. Yes? Easy.
Yes.
Okay. Excellent. Okay, we were discussing about the grammar. In that case was the present, continuous or present progressive. Yes? And we were discussing about how we're going to use this structure about that. Yes, we have the subject, we have the verb. In that case, we have the verb be plus the verb plus the ing, and also we have the complement. Yes, we have here some examples. She is wearing shoes. He is watching a movie. Easy.
Yes, teacher.
Good. So we have here some information about how we're going to use them. Yes, we have the present continuous, and we also have the affirmative, the negative, and also the interrogative, right? And we have here some examples. I am working. I am not working. Am I working? Yes. When you are going to say or do a question, you are going to write at first the verb to be, and then the subject, and then the verb plus ing, and don't forget to use the question. Easy. Easy?
Easy, teacher.
Excellent. So we have here the information that how we're going to use the present continuous, right? Okay. Tell me when we're going to use the present continuous.
Are you a student?
La actividad que estamos haciendo sería.
Yes. When you are going to say, I am studying.
Studying.
Yes. Good. Yes. Cuando dice, I am a student, está utilizando el pronoun.
El present.
Yes, simple present. Yes. I am
yes.
a student. The verb to be, the article, and a complement. And now in this case, a student. Yes? Good.
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. Okay, do you remember about the rules of the present continuous? The basic rules. Generally, we're going to use the ing for almost all the verbs, but we have some exceptions that you remember that we were discussing about when we're going to use the verbs with one syllable, when the one syllable is consonant, vowel, consonant, and also when at the end it has the stress vowel. ¿Se recuerda de eso?
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. Okay, good. And we also were discussing about when we're going to change some letters and we are going to add another letter. For example, lie, lying. Yes. We're going to change I and E, and we're going to add Y, and also we're going to add ing. Yes. Easy.
Easy, teacher.
Good, excellent. And we were discussing about when we're going to drop the E and we're going to add just ing, right? We're going to eliminate the last E, in this case, this one. And we're going to add ing. Easy. Yes.
Easy, teacher.
Question?
Yes. I not question.
Okay, I don't have any question. Excellent. Okay, we were discussing how we're going to do the present continuous question or the question in the present continuous tense using the yes, no question. Why is yes, no question? Because we're going to say yes, yes or no. Yes? How we're going to do those questions? Tell me. ¿Cómo vamos a hacer esas preguntas?
ing.
And don't forget the question mark. Okay, don't forget to use the question mark when you are going to do questions. Yes? Okay, we were discussing here some examples how we're going to do the questions. Yes? We were working with the answer. Yes, don't forget, and please remember that when we're going to answer the question, we're going to say, yes, I am going to, and blah, blah, blah. Or yes, I'm going, or yes, I am. Or just to say yes, but don't say yes, I'm. No me vaya a contratar I'm porque gramaticalmente eso no es correcto. Yes?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Yeah. Good. So we were discussing something about some questions. Yes? And this one was for am I? And also we were discussing is he? Yes? And also are you? Yes? And plurals, right? ¿Esto es plural o singular? People.
Plural.
Plural, plural, right? Because the singular is person. Okay, so we were discussing about this short conversation, how we're going to use it when we're going to talk or ask questions. Yes, in our daily speaking. Easy. Easy?
It's easy, teacher. Easy, teacher.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Tell me about the time. What or which is the question that we're going to use for ask about the time? ¿Cuál es la pregunta que vamos a usar para...
What time is it?
Ah, excellent. Perfect. Yes. ¿Recuerdan de esto, de las keywords?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, yes. Tell me when we're going to use a past. Uh-huh.
It's 20 past 8.
Okay, excellent. Good. So, excellent. So, how we're going to call to this thing over here, the largest. ¿Cómo le vamos a llamar a esa manecilla? En inglés. ¿Cómo? ¿Cómo le vamos a llamar a esta?
Minute hands.
Okay, minute hand. Excellent. And the shortest?
Hours hand.
Hours hand. And the other one?
Hands. Second hands.
Second hand. Excellent. Thank you. Okay, so when we're
¿Y por qué los tres terminan en hands, teacher?
Ah, porque como son manecillas, entonces el inglés es algo extraño. Entonces, a las tres les pusieron hands.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, ahí sí no le pudiera dar una explicación más amplia con respecto a eso.
Teacher, okay. En la lógica, me imagino que como la gran mayoría de relojes, ¿verdad? Trae su ¿cómo sería su regulador de minutos, horas y segundos? Entonces, usted lo maneja con la mano. Me imagino yo que por eso le ponen hands, ¿vea?
Ah, buena explicación.
Una lógica. Ajá.
O son okay. Manecillas, como lo conocemos aquí, las manecillas del reloj.
Ajá, a las tres le decimos manecilla. No. Ajá.
Sí, las manecillas del reloj.
Espera, teacher.
¿Mande?
Entonces una sería la horaria,
la secundera,
y la minutera.
Yes, exacto. Yes. Ok. No sé si les quedó claro.
La secundera, ¿cómo dijo que se pronunciaba?
Second hand.
Ah, ok.
Yes. Okay, any other question? Yes, yes, no, no.
Yes, teacher.
No, teacher.
Yes, teacher, ahí como it's noon, es mediodía, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Ok.
Yes. Ya me quedé corta como, ay, quiero ver cómo era. ¿Cómo identificar que era de tarde, de noche? ¿Cuándo íbamos a utilizar tú o quarter, creo que era?
Ah, ok. So, recuerden que cuando esté la aguja, la minutera, del 12 al 30, del lado derecho, si se fijan, por eso se los sombría un poco, porque vamos a utilizar el past y el after. Yes, es como para decir, son las, son 10 pasadas las 3, por poner un ejemplo. En este caso, son 15 minutos pasadas las 6. Pasado o after. Cuando vamos a utilizar el to, es cuando la manecilla de la segundera está del 31, por decirlo así, al 59. Vamos a decir que es que falta para la siguiente hora. ¿Yes? Así como, por ejemplo, son las 7:40. Ajá, ¿cómo sería? 22:08. ¿Yes? No sé si me doy a entender. Como en español decimos, son 20 para las 4. Cuarto a las 3. Cuando falta, digamos, 15, 20, 35 para la siguiente hora. Por eso aquí le hemos puesto, it's a quarter to 7. Que está diciendo que es un cuarto para las 7.
Para las 7.
Yes. Podemos utilizarlo así o podemos decir que son las... Son las 6:45. Yes. En su libro tienen dos formas de decirlo. Y es 6:45 or a quarter, it's a quarter to 7. Si usted se quiere escuchar así más de caché, más piqui, pues usa esta hora. It's a quarter to 7. Nos va a dejar en la luna. Ah, ¿qué dijiste, Lawrence? No sé si me doy a entender.
Yes, teacher.
¿Sí?
Yes, teacher.
Excelente. Para eso sirven estos repasos. Ok, este. ¿Cuándo lo vamos a utilizar?
Cuando va de un minuto hasta 9.
Excelente. Yay. Good. This one. It's o'clock. ¿Cuándo vamos a usar el o'clock?
Cuando es el punto, la hora.
Cuando sea.
Excelente. Sea una hora completa, ¿ok? O'clock. Yes.
En punto.
Yes. En este caso tenemos las 12 en punto, las 12 p.m. O le podemos poner it's noon or it's midnight. Midday, sorry, midday. Es mediodía, es este noon o p.m. Yes. Cualquiera de esos lo vamos a utilizar para las 12.
Entonces no es correcto decir it's noon, midday.
It's mid, no. Esto es separado. Yes. O dice noon o dice midday.
Okay.
Got it? Questions? Hasta ahorita?
No question.
Excellent. Thank you. It's 12 o'clock. It's 12 a.m. or it's midday. Midnight, sorry. Midnight. Yeah, se me lengua la traba. Okay, easy.
Easy.
Okay. We were discussing about these times. Yes. We were discussing about the 3 o'clock. ¿Cómo se dice este?
5:02:05.
It's 4:05. Oh.
Yes.
Yes.
4:05.
Uh-huh. 4:05. Or by past four. En B. Pero como dijimos que del 1 al 9 vamos a ocupar O, entonces ocupamos el O, right?
Four or five.
Four or five.
No. Sería. Sí. No, past. By. Past four or five. No, sorry. Four or five. Yes. Sí, está correcto. Sí. Perdón. Okay. Number three. Bueno, teacher, ¿puede o no puede más?
After.
Ajá.
It's 5 to 25.
¿Cómo es?
Four after.
Recuerden que aquí la horaria es la del 5.
It's 5 to 5, teacher.
Yes. Okay, faltan 5 para las 5.
5 to 5.
Yes. 5. 5:50. Yes. 5:55. Yes. Good. Excellent. Okay. So we were discussing about the WH question with the verb be. Do you remember about that? ¿Se recuerda de eso?
Yeah, I remember, teacher.
Okay, yes. Easy.
No tan easy, pero.
Teacher,
mande.
Ahí en el cuadrito donde dice B plus ING. Donde está taking, ¿es taking o es taking?
Taking.
Ok, le falta la L, ¿verdad?
Taking. De tomar, de take.
Take.
Dicho, una pregunta.
Mande.
Sí, todas estas palabras que empiezan con WH, ¿se usan en todos los pronombres o hay excepciones?
No, no hay excepciones. Hasta con nombres los puede usar. Pero recuerde que va a decir, where is María, por ejemplo. En vez de she, puede poner María. Where is María? ¿Yes? Recuerde que en este caso estamos utilizando con el verbo to be. Yes. Entonces, where is María? O what is María doing? Por ejemplo. Yes. Who is the person that you were walking yesterday? ¿Quién era la persona con la que ibas caminando ayer? Podría ser otro ejemplo. Pero ese ya es en pasado. Yes. No sé si se les quedó claro. Yes, okay. Excellent.
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Teacher, y el who se podría usar con are también.
Yes, who are you? Who are you? ¿Quién eres? Who are you?
Amo.
Puedo usarlo con los tres.
Solo when, why, también con los tres.
Con los tres, todos estos. Uy, se mueve todo esto. Yes, easy.
Yes.
Okay. Do you remember that we were discussing about these activities? Okay, tell me the example for the first one.
He is playing tennis.
Excellent.
He is
playing tennis.
Or is he playing tennis?
Oh, that is the question. Excellent. Hoy háganme una WH. Who is playing tennis?
Who's playing Who's playing now tennis? Así sería bien la formulada.
¿Cómo sería?
Where is playing tennis?
Yes. Sí, dígame
la question is who playing no tennis? No, tennis.
Who is playing?
Who's playing tennis? Así.
Yes.
Okay.
Who is playing tennis?
Thank you, teacher.
Okay. Excellent. And I don't know if you have any question with this. Yes. And don't forget to use the question mark at the end. Cuando haga pregunta, no se le olvide de poner el signo de interrogación al final. Okay, we almost finished, but do you remember? That was easy, this homework, right? Thank you for your send me your homework. That today, that was the last homework for the level number one. And before we end the class, I will stop to sharing right now. I don't know if you have any question. No sé si tienen alguna pregunta.
Hay una question.
Okay, so antes que terminemos, no se me vaya a ir. Yes.
Teacher, una pregunta. Todos los videos y estas informaciones van a quedar siempre para poder estarlas viendo. O las quitan.
No, ahí están en la plataforma y además si ustedes se meten en inglés corporativo en YouTube, si escribe, se mete a YouTube y escribe inglés corporativo, ahí va a aparecer una infinidad de videos de todas las clases de nosotros y además de los otros grupos, de los otros maestros también. Ahí puede elegir cualquier video, ver el tema que usted quiera. Y en la plataforma están estos videos de nuestras clases.
Pero mejor meterse en el enlace porque mucho cuesta encontrarlo.
A veces póngale la clave, le voy a dar. Las mías las puede encontrar como escribiéndole day one, day two, así. Porque no todos le ponemos diferentes, pero yo soy de las pocas que le ponen day one, day two, day three, para poner clase uno, clase dos, pero en inglés.
Vaya, será así, la voy a buscar porque a veces se me pierde el enlace.
Ok, good. Antes de que terminemos, les voy a pasar la última vez la lista. Así que me ayuda ahí, por favor, en decir present, I'm here. Ok, solo regálenme un segundo. Voy a buscar.
Esta es la última clase.
Yes. Pero
de la primera que pasó,
¿mande?
No alcancé a poner el audio. No sé si me puso present.
Ah, espérame, ahorita vamos a pasar nuevamente la lista y ahí me dice present. Ok, Karen Lizeth.
Present, teacher.
Ok, thank you, Catherine Liliana. Lourdes Rocibel.
I'm here.
Thank you, Luis Mario.
Present.
Thank you, Luisa Cheyenne. Thank you, Luisa Cheyenne. Magali Rachel.
Present.
Thank you. Marilyn Diana.
Present.
Thank you. María Amalia.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. María Angelina.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. María Ruth.
Present.
Thank you. Marielos Guadalupe.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Marta Roxana. Marta Stephanie.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Mirna Elizabeth. Mónica María.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Moris Isaí. Noemí Lizeth.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Olga Lilian.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Paolo. Rafael Alexander. Ronald Giovanni.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Rosa María del Milagro.
Here I am.
Thank you. Samuel Isaí. Sandra Maritza.
Present.
Thank you. Sandra Melissa.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Santos Miguel.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Silvia Esperanza.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Sonia Giselle.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Soraya Guadalupe.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Thelma Guadalupe.
Present teacher.
Okay. Thank you, everybody.
Teacher, una consultita con respecto al correo que nos enviarían si estamos acreedores de la beca para el segundo módulo, ¿por qué día nos caería?
Quiero ver, lunes, creería yo que mañana o el día lunes, creería yo.
Ok, y sería como el inicio de este módulo que empezamos martes, y sería de martes a viernes y luego se normalizaría.
Sí, creería yo que sí, pero un día me estaban contando de que como que les dan una semana de descanso, pero no estoy muy segura. Así que estén pendientes de su correo y le han estado enviando nuevamente solicitándole sus documentaciones. Es para un recordatorio, ¿verdad? A los que ya... ya los enviaron a hacer caso omiso de ese correo. Si no lo ha enviado, envíelo, por favor, porque me manifestaron de que no quieren que nadie se quede sin inscribirse. Así que, por favor, ahí manden la información si no la han enviado y si no hacen caso omiso. Así que,
mande. Pensé que a mí me estuvieron mandando la semana pasada y me decían de que gracias por inscribirme. Y aparecían en fechas y aparecía ya, se suponía, ¿verdad? Que estaba inscrita para el otro, pero no sé si será ese o van a mandar otro. Y allí aparecía que la fecha tentativa era el 22 para empezar.
Ah, bueno. Entonces, sí, van a tener quiero ver. 22 sería el lunes.
Que
23. Sí, si es corrido va a ser el día 23. Creería yo.
Teacher, ¿y nos unirían a otro grupo o estaríamos siempre en el mismo grupo de WhatsApp?
Ahí sí le fallo. Ahí sí no sabría poder explicarle, pero si no, ahí, o sea, no se vayan a salir del chat todavía, sino que permanezcan ahí. Si los mueven, pues los van a mover y si no, pues ahí se van a mantener.
Teacher.
Ande.
Tengo una duda, en cuanto... que en la plataforma, cuando revisamos lo de nuestro progreso, es normal que siempre nos aparezca como asistente, como les aparece a varios.
Sí, yo creo que sí.
Porque ahí dice que si está como asistente, como que no le dan el certificado o algo así, entonces, por eso era mi duda, pero veo que a varios les aparece así, así que no sé.
Déjeme consultarlo el día de mañana. Sí, yo creo que a todos les aparece. Déjenme consultar mañana, pero yo creería de que no, porque les tienen que dar el diploma. Así que déjenme preguntar el día de mañana y yo les voy a estar informando.
Ok, teacher, muchas gracias.
Fue un placer para mí ser su docente durante este nivel 1. Si ya no los veo, sigan estudiando, pónganse más las pilas. La idea es que aprendan inglés, ¿verdad? Así que si ya no nos volvemos a ver, fue un gusto haberles podido ayudar. Si les ayudé, si les solventé algunas dudas, ustedes tienen mi número de teléfono. Si necesitan algún día un refuerzo, mire, teacher, necesito que me explique este tema. Aunque yo ya no sea su docente, con mucho gusto les puedo ayudar, ¿ok?
Muchas gracias.
Gracias.
Te agradecemos mucho, teacher.
Nada.
Gracias por todo, teacher.
Juntos, juntos también para nosotros. Que sí aprendimos mucho.
Ok. Sí. I'm glad to hear
that. De cero.
Okay.
Gracias teacher, por todo.
De nada. Ahí estamos.
Bendiciones, okay. Teacher. Gracias.
También bendiciones para ustedes también.
Ha sido un gusto.
Gracias, teacher. Fue un gusto haber estado con usted.
Gracias.
Muchas gracias por todo.
Okay. Bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Take care.
Bye, teacher.
Bye.
Bye.
Teacher.
Bye.
See you. Weekend.
Happy weekend.
Ay, señor bendito.